Hi, my name is Marco, and today I want to talk about axes. Rows profiles are represented in coordinate system, where each reading is represented by a point of coordinates. Coordinates are linked to reference lines, called coordinate axes or just axes. The horizontal axis spans the roasting time, and the vertical axis, the measured temperatures. The axes allow to exactly interpret each point of the profile. The rate of rise curve is computed from the temperature signal and represents the speed of temperature changes, displayed along a separate horizontal axis on the right. The layout of the axis is configured in the axis dialog, which is opened via the corresponding menu item of the config menu. The dialog has 5 sections, each with configurations for a specific part. While the default axis settings are fine for most situations, it is good to know the function of each of those controls. Hovering with the mouse over each control shows a short hint on its function, but most of those require a few more explanations. In this short note, I will explain how to configure the Artisan axis system to represent roast profiles in the most useful way. Let's roast this. We want to set the range of the temperatures such that all of our readings are displayed, but keep it minimal, not to waste screen estate. In the temperature section of the axis dialog, we set the minimum temperature limit to 60 and the maximum limit to 220 to get our beam temperature curve just in range. We also increase the step size of the tick step to 50 to reduce the number of axis labels. That mystic 100% event step field will be covered in a minute. Let's turn to the time axis, which is configured in the first section of the axis dialog. Again, we can set the axis limits and the tick labels step size to some reasonable values, but here we have some more options. If auto is not ticked, the auto time axis mode is disabled. This allows to have custom limits defined per profile, which are saved along profiles and reset on load if load from profile is ticked. In some situations, it makes sense to lock the time axis to a certain range, such that the stored axis settings on loading a series of profiles do not alter them. This can make separate profile printouts easier to compare. In most other situations, the automatic time axis mode is best. If the auto flag is ticked, Artisan selects reasonable limits based on the loaded profile data. It is either focusing just on the roast including the between batch protocol, or just the between batch protocol. There's a second set of time axis limits tagged record. Those apply on starting a recording. The default is to start with a max time limit of 10 minutes. If the expand flag is ticked, the time axis is automatically extended by 3 minutes as soon as a roast is about to run beyond the current limit. The rate of rise axis is hidden if no rate of rise curve is available or none is to be displayed. Let's activate it. Again, the range of values to be displayed can be configured. If one of those auto flags is ticked, the rate of rise axis max limit is selected such that the corresponding rate of rise curve gets fully displayed.
a legend can be placed and grid lines can be drawn at the major tick locations. Oh, this legend can be moved. There is one more y-axis. This one is not drawn on the screen, but operates behind the scenes to locate the event marks. The event dialog allows to configure the rendering of event marks. Events can be drawn as flag annotations on the beam temperature curve, in a separate bar graph, as step graph in combination with flag annotations, or as step graph with annotated values. A click on a node of the step graph shows its value in the message line. But how to configure the minimum and maximum access limits to adjust the placement of the events in such a step graph? By default, the 100% event value is located just below the faces bar. By changing the faces bar lowest limit in the faces dialog, the event marks move accordingly. In step mode, which can be activated in the events dialog, the zero event value is still aligned to the zero temperature value. But the 100% event value is now aligned with the temperature 100. Finally, one can put a temperature value into the 100% step field of the axis dialog to have those 100% event values be aligned with it. In this case, the zero event value is aligned with the minimum temperature axis limit to keep all event marks in the graph. Okay, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial and you will join in for the next one. Thanks for watching and have a good day.